Hey, in this video I will show you one of the most common problems with the brew group for Saeco Royal Magic and Vienna. And actually they use basically the same brew group with the small details that are different for each model. So first, if you have Saeco Royal, there are two type of outlet pipes, this here. So the whole brew group is the same. The only difference is in this outlet pipe. So you can see the two types. One type have a rubber O-ring in the end, the other one doesn't have. So how can you know which one you need? Is like if you see your dispenser, this is the three type of dispensers that use Magic and Royal. You can see one of the three, this end here is rubber, so you don't need this O-ring here. So if your dispenser is this type, you need the brew group. Everything is the same, but only this pipe is different because this is rubber and you don't need O-ring here. The other two types of dispenser, this place here, this piece here is plastic. And you need this O-ring to make sure you have a tight seal here, as you can see. And the other one is the same plastic, and you need this O-ring. And this is how to know what you need for Saeco Royal. There is everything else is the same. The only difference is in this outlet pipe, and you have these three dispensers, so you now can know what you need for your brew group. The other for Vienna, the brew group is absolutely the same, but let me show you. You need to remove this piece here and let me show you. Okay, you have this block, the piston on the place, so you have to push it to remove it. So if you have a Royal, this static piston is like this. If you want to change it to Vienna, you have to rotate it 90 degrees. So the hole is this side here. And here is the Vienna outlet pipe. You screw this like this, and you have Vienna. Your brew group is okay for Vienna, to use it on the Vienna model. It's everything else again is the same. So this is how you can change your brew group from one model to another model, and how to actually recognize what exactly you need to prepare your brew group. So now we're going to start with the problems with your brew group. Okay, so you have the brew group again. And there is a few problems with the leaks from the brew group, and the first leak is when you make a few coffees, and here inside the brew group you can see a coffee here. So what is the main reason for this? First, you have to unscrew this here, and again from here the coffee can overflow on your waste coffee container, and if you see water inside with the coffee, you have some sort of this problem or something else. But first I will show you what is the problem when you have coffee here. So first you remove this piece. The first thing you can check is this O-ring can be damaged and leak from here. This is number one reason. The next reason is sometimes people screw this very tight, and actually this plastic piece here is very often is broken, one of these, and let me show you if you can see here. The one is okay, the other is broken where the screw goes. So what is happened, the pipe goes like this and the coffee leaks inside. So the cheapest way to repair this is to remove the old screw and find the screw with longer screw, so you can screw it back. Or you can buy the whole piston, static piston, but this is the cheapest way. So first you can check this O-ring. After that you can check these plastic pieces if they are broken, and let me remove this. If these two things are okay, you have to check, let me show you, this pin here. So what is the problem with this pin is that you can see there is a O-ring, it can be damaged and leak from here, or with the time, as you can see, this is the old one with the defect. Here you have a brass piece, it's inside the plastic, but with the time hot water and pressure pull this brass piece out, and actually what happened, it cannot go all the way and start to leak. So you have to probably, if you have leaks, this can occur, and you, of course, you have to replace it with the new one. So the new one is a little bit smaller, but it's work perfectly. This is the new. You can see how shiny it is here. And something else, when you replace it, don't use too much force, because it's a plastic, and sooner or later, if it's too tight, the brass piece will come out and you will have a leak again. And the other problem, it could be defect on the plastic, and you can have a somewhere here crack and leak to be from the plastic. So then you can replace, here's the glass bowl. You have to replace the whole cylinder, not cylinder, piston. And if you have water here, also can be because this O-ring is wear and doesn't hold water and start to drip coffee inside the box for the waste coffee. So this is from here, but the problem is from here. If you have leaks, most of the time the leak will be coffee and not water. So if it's coffee, most of the time is from this piece here. So the other thing is, as you can see, most of the old brew group have a metal screen here, filter screen. And what it's happened, again, you will have a lot of water here. Under this metal screen, you have space, and this space start to accumulate debris and cannot work properly. So again, you will have, if under this screen you have a lot of debris, you will have water inside your container. And if you have a water under your brew group, you can have a leak from here, from this piece here, okay, from this piece here. Sometimes you have to change the O-ring or the whole plastic piece. And if you have leaks from here, from your piston, that means inside the your what was that? Wait, your cylinder have a O-ring, and if he is damaged, you have to replace the whole cylinder. There is no replacement for this O-ring here. So I will show you now. Again, we disassemble this piece, how to disassemble your machine to make it clean and lubricate, because if it's not lubricated, it's not going to work very good. So first, there is, I don't put this, you have a screw here. I don't have it, but you have to unscrew this to remove this piece here. And you have three bolts. First, of course, you have to remove this piston, static piston here, and then to remove the three bolts. Before I start the video, I cleaned the brew group. It's easy now to only lubricate and assemble the brew group on one video. Okay. Okay. Now we can make it like this. Okay, so it's clean, but if you're disassembling your, first clean it and then lubricate it. So now I will remove this, and now something to remove this piece here, this plastic. You have to be very careful. You can see with the thin screwdriver how I can, because it's like this, because sometimes you can break this piece here, and I can remove the piston. So now I will use lubricant from This brand, it's a German brand, it's a very good lubricant, so it's for the food industry. And something else is good, that is silicone based lubricant, and the hot water will not wash away the lubricant. So I use this type. You can buy this small, it's for Gage and Seiko, but it's very expensive and it's only 5 grams. And this is maybe for the same price, you have 45 grams of lubricant. It's the same. It's not need to be branded with Saeco or Gage, and it's more expensive and it's very small amount. So first I open this here. You can use your finger. Okay. I will put here. So this piston, if you can see, from one side you have a small hole, from the other side you have a bigger hole. So this bigger hole has to go here, not like this. Okay, so when you have the piston, the big hole has to be the back side of the piston, something like this. Okay, the big hole goes on the back, the small hole is here. So now I will use I will use these screwdrivers to, and don't put a lot of lubricant, because if you put a lot of lubricant, the coffee debris will stack on this and it's very hard to clean it after a few times. You can see here this, and now you can feel how smooth is moving the piston. So now I have to put lubricant here. Okay. And of course here. Again, not much, because you don't want to have coffee here. So now this have to go like this. Okay, so now we have to put lubricant on this here, it's very important, and here, not much, again, it's, you don't need to put a lot, the other half also. Here is very important to have. Okay. It's not much, but it's enough for the machine to work properly. So now, something else. When you assemble this inside piece with the two sides, be careful to not put, you can see here, you can accidentally put it on this hole here. And when you close the other half, it will be blocked. Okay, so be careful this piece here to be like this. Okay, so now and push. Okay, so now you have to the three screws. And now I will replace some of the O-rings that is good to replace it. Okay, so now I will put this new one. This is the old version, gray, and this is the black, so it doesn't matter the color. This is the new version, so you can see it's a little bit different with the holes, but it's working perfectly, so don't worry if you want to put the black one. So here, and you have to screw here the screw. I don't have it, but don't forget this screw. The next thing, I will replace this O-ring with new O-ring. Okay, now I will put the new pin here. And actually I will use and again not too much force. This is enough. No need to make it very hard. So now if you, this is very important for this piece here that is go inside the hole. So first you put the glass bowl inside, then the spring has the smaller diameter and the bigger diameter. So the smaller diameter goes down and the bigger diameter, the spring is up. I will replace the O-ring here with new and here. And again, these screws here in the plastic, don't use too much force, because the plastic will break. Okay, and here. The last O-ring is this one. I will remove it and put the new one. Okay, so this is how, let me, oh, you can see here, you can see, I told you for this, and I cannot move, so I have to unscrew. Let me see if I can, yes. Okay, you can see, you have to be careful for this, because if you put it on your machine, something will break. So when you're finished with the glue group, you need to push this and try to see if everything is moving as it should be. So if it's smooth, it's ready to put it on your machine. So this is the most common problem with your machine and how to replace some of your O-rings and other things on the brew group. Bye.